Hi everyone, welcome back. Today sharing one of the most popular recipe that's hugely loved all over the world, and that's butter chicken. It's also known as murg makhni. Let's learn how to make the best butter chicken at home in a very simple way. Hope you like it. Keep watching. So firstly, we need to marinate the chicken. For that, here I have taken around 500 grams of chicken breast, that's boneless, and I have cut it into 1.5 inch cube size. Now clean and wash it thoroughly, and then we'll start with the marination. So to this, add salt as per taste and juice of 1 lemon, and then give it a nice mix. Once it's mixed well, then add in 2 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste, that's adrak lahsun ka paste, and then goes in 2 tablespoons of Kashmiri red chili powder. This will give a nice color to the chicken, and then give it a nice mix again. Making butter chicken is very simple. All we need to do is marinate it and then fry the chicken and prepare the buttery gravy, which we will see it in the later stage. Now once it's mixed well, finally add 2 tablespoons of thick yogurt or curd and mix again. Then allow it to marinate for 30 minutes. The longer you marinate, the more tender the chicken will be. While this is getting marinated, let's see what are the ingredients that are required to prepare creamy sauce. For this, I have taken 1 big onion that's roughly chopped, 4 big tomatoes that's roughly sliced, 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic or adrak lehsun ka paste, then 2 tablespoons of Kashmiri red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of dry fenugreek leaves, that's kasuri methi, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala, then 2 teaspoons of roasted coriander cumin seeds that I have crushed it, which is also known as kuta hua dhania zira powder, salt as per taste. Then we require 50 grams of cashew, that is kaju, butter and cream. Now let's start our cooking process. Chicken is well marinated, as you can see. So let's start pan frying them. For that, add little oil, say around 1 tablespoon, and allow it to heat up. And then to it add the marinated pieces. Now we're going to shallow fry these pieces and cook the chicken until it's 90% done. It's a one pan dish, as we're going to make the gravy into the same pan once chicken are done. And it will taste absolutely flavorful and delicious. Once we have added all the chickens, fry it until it's 90% done. It took around 10 minutes to shallow fry the chickens, and it's well done now. So transfer it into a plate, and then we move on to our next step. We're going to make the gravy into the same saucepan. Let's learn how to make it. Into the same oil, add 3 tablespoons of butter and allow it to melt. Be a little generous in adding the butter. Until now, the flame is on medium. Once the butter melts completely, then we can add chopped onions into it. So add in the chopped onions and saute it well. While the onions are getting sauteed, add in salt as required and then saute for a minute. Then to it add ginger garlic paste and saute until the raw aroma goes away. It's been 2 minutes, I've been sauteing it. Now it's time to add our spice powders. So here goes in the cumin coriander powder that I have roasted and crushed, followed by the garam masala. Mix it well and then saute it for a minute. Once it's well sauteed, add in the tomatoes and mix it again. Now we're going to cover and cook the tomatoes until it turns soft. This homemade butter chicken with simple ingredients that's easily available at a kitchen will taste way better than any store-bought masala powder. Do try this and you will find the difference. Now tomatoes have turned soft. It's time to add cashews now, that's kaju. and then add 1 tablespoon of sugar. That's completely optional. And then mix it well. Now to this add 1/2 cup of water and allow the mixture to cook for 5 minutes. The mixture has been cooking for 5 minutes now. So it's time to switch it off and allow the mixture to cool down completely. Now we're gonna grind this mixture into a fine puree. If the mixture is more, try to grind it in 2 batches as I have done it. And then we're gonna strain out the puree completely to get a velvety, silky puree texture. So press and extract as much as you can and ensure there is only very less wastage. That's hardly you can see the skin and seeds of tomatoes left. That's it. Our silky smooth puree is ready. This is how we want. Now as a puree and a fried chicken are ready, let's move to the final step, that's tempering. For that, preheat a pan and add around 2 tablespoons of butter. Keep the flame on very low. Now allow this butter to melt and then to this add Kashmiri red chili powder. And the moment you add it, immediately add the puree and mix it well. Otherwise, the powder might get burned and it will change the taste of our butter chicken. So immediately add the puree and allow it to come to a boil. Once the gravy comes to a boil, then it's time to add the fried chickens into it and then allow it to simmer for 5 minutes or until the chicken gets cooked completely. It's been simmering for 5 minutes now. So finally add 2 tablespoons of cream and then add crushed fenugreek leaves. So crush the leaves and then add it. And that's it. Give it a nice mix and allow this to simmer for another 2 to 3 minutes. A super flavorful, creamy and a deliciously rich butter chicken or murg makhni is absolutely ready. Isn't this very simple to make? It's one of the best butter chicken you would have ever tried it. While serving, just add a spoonful of cream and sprinkle little fenugreek leaves and enjoy it with your family and friends. They will truly love it and will be highly impressed. So do try this awesome recipe and serve it with zira rice, naan or pulao. Hope you like this delicious recipe. If so, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so and also like and share it. Soon we'll be coming up with another interesting recipe. Until then, take care of yourself. Happy cooking. Bye-bye.